subscribe to our channel and don't forget to click on bell icon to get new video notifications.
Hello and welcome to Tech Gadgets. Today I'm going to show you the all new Mahindra XUV500. Before going to the car, I would like to thank Mahindra showroom Karimnagar for allowing me to shoot the all new XUV500 facelift version. And if you want to purchase any Mahindra car, you can contact the number given below. They have all varieties of cars from KUV Next to Mahindra XUV500 to TUV300 as well. So they have commercial vehicles as well. Mahindra XUV500 is now 7 years old and it's received a number of little updates over the years. As Mahindra continued to fine-tune its flagship SUV, on the face of things, this update is another facelift, but underneath look a fair few interior tweaks and also some significant changes under the bonnet. This is a much needed update as of late the XUV500 has been facing tough competition from both Tata Hexa and Jeep Compass. So does the 2018 iteration do enough to re-establish dominance in the segment? So what's new in this car? The most obvious change to the XUV500 is the new grille that now features large opening accented with chrome crowns and chrome surround as well. There is also a new layout for the headlamps again, and now the LED DRLs have migrated to the top of the headlamp unit, and the fog lights surround have also received a minor tweak, and that wraps up the changes to the face as well. On the side of the car, there is a new set of chrome accents on the both of the door grills, the bigger change of side profiles as well. However, the new set of 18-inch diamond cut alloy wheels that replaced the 17-inches in the previous version. And the rear of XUV500 has received the biggest change through the D-pillar mounted lights have now given way to nice set of triangular units. The ascent lines on the boot lid have changed and there's a large chrome ascent that runs just above the number plate. Looking back at the XUV500 has changed over the years, feeling that the first iteration from 2011, while it whisker grills in the front bumper looked just a little meaner as well. On the inside, Mahindra has made a few changes with the new quilted tan leather upholstery for the seats that look quite nice and feel good as well. And the upper portion of the dashboard is now covered in black leather while the rest is black plastic as well. And the center control that houses the buttons and controls for the infotainment, aircon and other functions now has a piano black surround. And while this does look quite nice when it is clean, it's a fingerprint magnet and quickly loses its sheen with heavy usage as well. So another change has come to the infotainment system, which is now Arkhamis tuned like Hyundai cars, but the sound quality is strictly MIDI-core. What is in MIDI-core is Mahindra's BlueSense Android and iOS app that connects to the infotainment system and allows you to control functions like the aircon and audio sources, and also displays vehicular info like the tire pressure and fuel level. For this update, Mahindra has even added smartwatch capabilities that allow compatible smartwatches normally connected to a user's phone to display the same information on the dial while also allowing you to similar control over aircon and audio sources as well. And when it comes to the mechanical bits, the XUV500 is powered by the same 2.2 turbocharged M-Hawk diesel and petrol engine, but the diesel features a new variable geometry turbo or VGT, and Mahindra has made tweaks to the VGT, which is now electrically actuated as opposed to the earlier pneumatic operation, and this makes the engine quicker to respond to throttle changes. And power figure has also jumped up from 140 PS to 155 PS, a 3750 RPM, and torque sees even bigger jump from 330 Nm to 360 Nm at a slightly higher from 750 to 2800 RPM. While the peak torque is available in a narrower spread than before, the XUV still drives as fluidly as it did, and the power delivery is nice and linear with just a slight surge around 2000 RPM. The clutch is also light and is steering, and through we only had the short time to review this, but the Mahindra is very good in good city conditions as well. Again, owing the limited time, there is a well describing how it feels in different road conditions as well. The petrol engine receives no updates and continues to put out 140 PS at 4500 RPM and 320 Nm at 2000 to 3000 RPM. The petrol will also continue to be exclusively available with a 6-speed conventional automatic transmission, while the diesel will be available with both a 6-speed manual and a 6-speed automatic as well. and the diesel will also still sport all-wheel drive in the top of the line W11 with either the 6-speed manual or 6-speed automatic transmissions as well. And what else is new in this 2018 facelift XUV500? Mahindra is also changing the way it names as well as the packages its variants this time around. And the new variants names are W5, W7, W9 and W11. Basically, the numbers have changed to odd numbers. And we also know that the petrol SUVs will be exclusively available with automatic transmission, but the diesel will continue to be a mix of both manual and automatic. Also, new is the flagship W11 optional variant, which is the only one to be offered with an all-wheel drive drivetrain along with 18-inch diamond cut alloy wheels as well. And the XUV500 still is a feature-rich SUV that ticks a lot of boxes and seats even 7. It still suffers from practicality, no luggage space when the third row is flipped up, and even the quality of the switches and the air vents are still good. The storage spaces could also be a little bit better throughout as well. The XUV features a Monarch chassis, that means its driving manners are respectable and body roll is fairly controlled. The steering is nicely weighted but could have been a little sharper, and the suspension setting also not changed, so it should be still feature the same ride quality which is on the firm side. And it also features a fairly comprehensive safety features list that comprises of 6 airbags, dual airbags as standard across variants, ABS, ESP, and there is a sunroof is also available in this variant. You can see there is a switch over there. If you switch on, then it will be opened in a small way to get air, or it will open totally. So now it will open totally. And it comes with disc brakes on all four wheels and hill hold and hill descent control in top two variants as well. When come to the pricing, I will tell you the pricing as well. And the transmission, however, is not smooth of disappointment. It's clunky, but there is a bit of a roll too in the facelift version. But the pricing is in an attractive way, and XUV500 managed to put the pricing in an attractive way. And the XUV500 doesn't see many changes in terms of features when compared to the outgoing model. And the 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system is still very much a part of the car with USB Bluetooth connectivity. And of course, there's Android Auto too, no Apple CarPlay yet on the car. And we know that this feature will be coming to the company's car soon, probably by 2019. And there is EcoSense 2 also connected apps. So what Mahindra has managed to do is get smartwatch connectivity as well. But there is a limitation on the brands that are compatible with the app, and hence dive deeper into what it feels like. The cabin, however, is not all new, as all the buttons on the center console, steering wheel and rest of the cabin, however, is not all new. And so everything is familiar. We all know that it comes with engine options of 2.2 liter diesel and 2.2 liter petrol option, and both the manual and automatic to offer as well. So as we have seen the power output of the new XUV, if you fold the last seats, then you will get a lot of storage space. Otherwise, you will not get that much of storage space if the third row is flipped up. And Mahindra is offering some new colors on the XUV500, Crimson Red and Mystic Copper, both of which, but the Crimson Red looked promising on the presentation board. Prices of XUV500 start at 12.32 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi, going all the way to 17.88 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi. And the prices have gone down as can be expected, but still they remain reasonably competitive. Mahindra will hope the refresh brings its customer back into M&M showrooms, and more importantly back to driving the once popular XUV500. And the base W5 version diesel one starts at 12.32 lakhs and all it's going up to W11 optional automatic going up to 18.98 lakhs, and the petrol G automatic starts at 15.43 lakhs. So these are all ex-showroom prices Delhi. And from second row you can go to the third row easily by flipping up the. So the XUV500 has always been a trailblazer of sorts, practicality, creating a segment for itself. And the 2018 update sees a welcome change to engine with more power and promise of better response as well. And the interior trim updates are welcome change, but there are still some niggles when it comes to finish and quality of some of the plastic parts. The Jeep Compass is more refined, a better quality offering, but a significant increase in budget as well. The Hexa offers more space and usable boot, even while seating 7, but a slight premium as well. Considering the price, the XUV500 still offers a lot of value for money. So hope that guys you like this update. Please comment and subscribe for my channel for more tech and auto related updates. Thank you.